Alright guys, Sunday morning, August 4th, roughly about 9:20. We're going to go meet this fella and get the rest of the hay. It's about 5 minutes away. We're supposed to meet him about 9:30, so let's get in the truck and go. Made it back to the house. So we actually got 12 bales on this load here. What we had to do, his tractor, he has a John Deere 5075E two-wheel drive, but his loader's a little bit too short to be putting hay on top. So we stacked two hay bales on the backpack here, and we had to strap it in really, really good because this one kept wanting to roll off. So as you can tell, it's hanging over the side of the trailer pretty good. We in his field, as y'all seen earlier, I lost my license plate, but found it. We got it back, so I have to put it back on with washers later. So what I'm gonna do, since this one's trying to roll off, I'll go ahead and spear it with the Kubota, and then we'll take the straps off. Whenever I put them on, I made sure to put the clamps on this side, just so that I don't have to be on this side at all, just in case it decides to try to roll off. But let me go get the tractor and we'll stab it right here real quick. Alright, folks. That makes, 11 on the first run, 12 on the second run, so 23 bales. And talking to him, he's going to be cutting again roughly in 3 weeks. So we're going to get 17 more, and that should give us a total of 40, which should get us through winter. So that's definitely a nice thing. Like I said, we'll see how many he has whenever he cuts, because if he has, I don't know, 22 of them, we'll probably just buy all 22. I don't want to leave him with 5 hay bales trying to find somebody to come get 5 hay bales. And it never hurts to have more. I store my hay outside. Eventually, we're going to build a hay barn somewhere out here. Really looking forward to that, because years like this year, hay has been great. It's been good rain, good weather. And it's been a great hay year. Everybody's came down on the prices a lot because demand's still what it was. Actually, I think demand probably dropped because a lot of people here locally had to sell their herds just to get by, because it was bad last summer, y'all. The Shelmet being one of those people. So talking to him, he seems like he's going to stay in the hay business, but I don't know if he's going to get cows again. And so seems like we're possibly going to have us a hay guy for the near future, which would be great. I got another guy I used to buy hay from, but he last year the drought was really bad. We couldn't get any hay from him. He didn't have hay. He had to go buy hay himself. And then this year he's having a lot of tractor problems. So the big benefit about using him, though, he does a 5x6 bale, which is bigger. These are 4x5s. And then on top of that, he delivers, which is definitely great too, because then I don't have to worry about anything. He takes care of all of it for me. But it's not that big a deal. This second guy takes roughly 10 minutes to get there probably, but he's 2 miles down the road. Probably about 3 miles down the road. Just by the time you weed in and out of everything, it's close to 10 minutes. So anyway, I'm gonna stop rambling. We got 23 bales. We're halfway through for this winter, which is doing great. Steers are doing great. I actually went and checked on the herd this morning. Should have brought y'all with me, because that would have been worthwhile, but I did not think about that, which it wasn't planned. I just fed the steers this morning, and I was like, you know what, let's go check on the rest of the herd. Anyway, that's it on this video. Hopefully we can pick back up our pace. Weather's being a lot better, and work's never slow. It's gonna be not as crazy as normal, or as it was these past 2 weeks, hopefully, and we'll go from there. Y'all have a wonderful day. Thanks for joining me on the farm. Y'all have a good one.